With me now from San Francisco is a Bloomberg tech reporter, Ed Ludlow, who's been covering these results all day and in the last few weeks. Hey, Ed, give us an idea what the threat could have been to Amazon and its business model if the workers there had voted to unionize.
I think largely, you know, the market viewed this as more important for the U.S. labor movement generally than really posing any real risk to Amazon's top or bottom line growth or indeed its business model. You have to remember, Amazon now has more than 1 million employees around the world, 1.3 million. In the U.S., it's second only to Walmart. And in Alabama, at question was around 5,500 workers. It's also not the first time that Amazon has faced a unionization movement. There was one in 2014 that didn't get very far. What's really changed, as you know, as I know, as the audience knows, is Amazon's like really in the public consciousness over the last 12 months. Because of the pandemic, lots of people have come to rely on Amazon.com to order things. You know, it's grown in such a massive way. And as part of that, it invested heavily in new fulfillment centers, new distribution centers. But because of all of that activity, because of all of those workers being in close proximity to one another during the pandemic, the focus then turned to working conditions. But if you read across Wall Street, there was never really any serious concern that this would lead to a dramatic impact to how Amazon operates its business.
Why do you think that is, Ed? Because it did seem like Amazon had a really aggressive campaign to prevent the employees there from unionizing. So if Wall Street wasn't worried about it, why did Amazon seem so worried about it?
Yeah, I think Amazon would argue that, look, we pay $15 an hour to our workers, twice the national average wage. We provide health benefits to our workers. And you know, from Amazon's point of view, they would argue that is better than some union workers already get. Amazon pushing back on unionization is not a new idea. It's been happening for 20 years since the company was founded. You know, on the union side, they are going to appeal the outcome of this particular vote. They say that essentially Amazon intimidated the workforce. You know, freedom of information request basically unveiled that Amazon had installed a postal box on site where, in close proximity to the offices where workers were posting their ballots, because it was a mail-in ballot. And Amazon countered saying, well, you know, it's optional. You didn't have to use that ballot. You know, the union argued, oh, Amazon held one-on-one meetings with employees and group meetings to basically outline the consequences of joining the union. Amazon said, no, those were information sessions for workers. So, you know, it has been very hard fought, the battle. It will be appealed. I don't think necessarily that it's going to go away in Alabama. The hope for the union was that this would just be the starting point, that if they were to succeed in Alabama, it would spread to other states. And part of that goes back to what I was just talking about. Amazon has grown in such a huge way. It's such a big employer. The potential for the labor movement was there. It just didn't happen this time around.
The biggest stories, the moment they happen, from around the globe. Subscribe to Bloomberg Quick Take now for insight in an instant.